The story begins in the summer of 1949, when a middle-aged school inspector from Egypt arrived at the small town of Greeley in Colorado. His name was Saeed Qutb. Qutb had been sent to the US to study its educational system, and he enrolled in the local state college. His photographs appear in the college yearbook. But Qutb was destined to become much more than a school inspector. Out of his experiences of America that summer, Qutb was going to develop a powerful set of ideas that would directly inspire those who flew the planes on the attack of September the 11th. As he had traveled across the country, Qutb had become increasingly disenchanted with America. The very things that on the surface made the country look prosperous and happy, Qutb saw as signs of an inner corruption and decay.
This was Truman's America, and many Americans today regard it as a golden age of their civilization. But for Qutb, he saw a sinister side in this. All around him was crassness, corruption, vulgarity, talk centered on movie stars and automobile prices. He was also very concerned that the inhabitants of Greeley spent a lot of time in lawn care, pruning their hedges, cutting their lawns. This, for Qutb, was indicative of the selfish and materialistic aspect of American life. Americans lived these isolated lives surrounded by their lawns. They lusted after material goods. And this, says Qutb quite succinctly, is the taste of America.
What Qutb believed he was seeing was a hidden and dangerous reality underneath the surface of ordinary American life. One summer night, he went to a dance at a local church hall. He later wrote that what he saw that night crystallized his vision.
He talks about how the pastor played on the gramophone one of the big band hits of the day, Baby, It's Cold Outside. He dimmed the lights so as to create a dreamy romantic effect. And then Qutb says that chests met chests, arms really circled waists, and the hall was outside. Full of lust and love.
I've got to go
but
away.
Baby, it's cold outside.
This evening has
been hoping that you'd drop.
To most people watching this dance, it would have been an innocent picture of youthful happiness. But Qutb saw something else. The dancers in front of him were tragic lost souls. They believed that they were free, but in reality, they were trapped by their own selfish and greedy desires. American society was not going forward. It was taking people backwards. They were becoming isolated beings, driven by primitive animal forces. Such creatures, Qutb believed, could corrode the very bonds that held society together. And he became determined that night to prevent this culture of selfish individualism taking over his own country.